Well, hi there. That person waving at you is me. I'm John Giannotti, sculptor. And I'm doing a casting demonstration in Haddonfield, New Jersey. We wanted to do this with actual voice, but there was so much noise and traffic that we decided to do a silent movie with a kind of Harrison Ford Blade Runner voiceover. So I apologize for that. But I'm doing a Hydrocal Plaster mold from a polyurethane silicone rubber mold that was made a few months ago with the help of master mold maker Joseph Caralfi. The Caralfi brothers, Joe and Angelo, learned their trade from their father, whom I call the master, Pietro Caralfi, who is one of the finest mold makers in the United States. This mold is of a sculpture of Walt Whitman. it is called I Sing the Body Electric. I'll talk about that more later in an actual live presentation instead of this silent movie that you're looking at. What I'm doing here is mixing up the hydrocal. You always add water to the hydrocal, never the other way around. And after you put in the amount that you need, after it forms little islands of plaster, you let it sit for about a minute. And here I am pouring it into the two sections of the mold. And now I will move the mold around to try to get the plaster to cover as much of the inner surface as possible. Now, of course, another way of doing this kind of casting, which is a simpler way, is to simply put the two halves of the plaster and rubber mold together and do a slush casting. But if I did it that way, the people who were watching would not be able to see exactly what I was doing. So we're doing it this way. Here I am hitting the mold against the table. Now, because it was outdoors, I had to use a little folding table. If you're doing it in your studio, you want to do that that jolting or that hitting of the plaster mold much harder on the table because you have to eliminate air pockets in the surface of the hydrocal. Then I take one of those cheap bristle brushes and take the plaster or hydrocal from the deep areas where it is several inches thick, and I start painting it over the details of the sculpture. Some of those details protrude quite a bit, the areas of the hairline, the nose, the mouth, the eyes. And in those areas, you have to make sure that you really push that hydrocal into the areas. As I'm doing this, the hydrocal is beginning to harden. And that's a good thing. As that happens, as it gets thicker, you'll find that the hydrocal will be able to stick to vertical surfaces, not just lay in puddles at the bottom. And so, by turning the mold carefully and trying to get areas as level as possible, you continue brushing until you get about from a quarter of an inch to a half an inch of the bare plaster. This is the called the slush casting, and the reason why this is done is because later on I'll have to reinforce this hydrocal with burlap and jute. And if we did not do the slush casting first, some of that burlap would show up on the surface and it would destroy the casting. So here I am hitting the mold again to try to release air pockets when when you see bubbles form on the top surface of what you're working on, you realize that the air pockets are mostly gone. As I work with the brush, You might notice that I am not taking much care at the top as far as the hydrocal overlapping the sides of the mold where the line is that separates the two molds. I'll take care of that later. It's actually easier to clean it up. And here is the inside of one of the molds and how it looks. You notice how the plaster overlaps the edges? That's not a problem. It will be a problem if you leave that plaster there, because then the two molds will not close up properly. So at this stage, what you have is a nice slush casting, and make sure again, as you see in that spot where there are a couple of air holes, make sure you push that plaster in properly so that you have no areas of the sculpture that are not completed. Once this process is done, you let this section harden slightly, and then you can begin adding the second layer, which can be done with soaking burlap into the hydrocal, or a jute or hemp, a material that will make the plaster extremely strong. If I tried to cast this piece in just solid plaster, it would weigh a tremendous amount, but also it would not be as strong as a hollow casting. So here's the first section of the mold completed with the slush cast. Now I'm mixing up plaster, and I'm making this plaster a little bit thinner, a little bit more watery than the first, and I'm dipping into it pieces of burlap. Now this is just not ordinary burlap that you can find in a fabric store, because the burlap has to have a very large opening so that the plaster itself can seep through it. It's almost as if you're laying up fiberglass, making a boat. And as I dip each piece, I drain it, and I lay it over a separate section. And you want to make sure that the burlap overlaps previous pieces of burlap as well, to make sure that it is very hard all over. Cut the burlap first into small sections so that it can be easily manipulated. And work it into the surface. And now when I do this part of it, I have to make sure, I have to be very careful about not letting any of that burlap overlap the edges of the rubber mold. If you do so, it will be impossible to remove that burlap, and therefore the two sections of the mold will not fit together properly. As you do this, make sure that you pat down the burlap, because you do not want an air space between this second layer and that first slush coat, because then you'll have weak areas that will possibly break later. And this is done carefully, and you make sure that you cover every section of the mold. In some areas, you might want to use jute, which is even stronger than the burlap, in areas that you feel need extra strength. So this is being laid up very carefully. And do this to both sides of the mold. Wait for that to harden, and or at least to get slightly harder, and then you can clean off those edges of the mold where the pieces will fit together. So here I am taking a scraping knife, and I'm carefully going over the rubber. And not only am I cleaning the plaster at that point, but I am turning the tool to about a 45 degree angle so that when I cut along that rubber edge, there will be a gap. So that when these two molds are put together, there will be a section that will accept plaster that will hold the two pieces together to get a finished casting. So here I am scraping that along at double speed. I don't work this quickly. And making sure that I have that nice 45 degree angle. Now, on the bottom of the mold, I'd like to make it a little bit thicker because it's an important part, and that's where it would crack eventually. And so I take some burlap or some jute and I roll it into small sections and lay it across the bottom by curling it up first and then laying it in so that the very bottom of the sculpture has is a little thicker than the rest. The entire casting is going to be approximately 3/4 of an inch thick. And you can mold it with your fingers so that the bottom casting is nice and even, even though later on after you place these two molds together, you can clean that entire bottom and not have any problems with it. So now I am ready to place these two molds together because the edges are clean and there is enough plaster. So I take one section of it and the other section, place them together, making sure that the registration marks that are on the rubber coincide, lay it on its surface, inspect it, take a look at the inside and see if everything lines up properly. And you can see here the thickness of that casting. Those little pieces of jute or burlap that are hanging down can be cleaned up later on either by burning it with a propane torch or covering it with another material. So now I have to join these two sections, and that can be done with clamps, it can be done with bolts. Here I'm using actually both. At the bottom, I am clamping the mold together now that I know that it's registered properly. And I am adding some bolts to the sides to make sure that they are nice and tight. Notice that the mold is flat on the very top. And it's flat because the next step will involve turning the mold literally on its head and adding plaster and jute this time, which is stronger than plaster. So I'm mixing up plaster now, or hydrocal, so that I can join the two halves of the mold together perfectly so that it is quite strong. Lay each piece in, make sure that it touches both sides of the mold and makes a nice strong seam line. The seam line can be a little bit thicker than the rest of the mold. That is really not that important. You just want to make sure that it is bonding to both sides of the casting. And I finished that up, and you can see that you have to get way down to the bottom to make sure that every section of seam line is completely filled. And here we have it. So here we are about to open the mold. It is the next day. Yesterday I did the demo outdoors. We didn't have time to open it yesterday. I like to wait a couple of hours before opening because Hydrocal, because it has Portland cement in it, expands a little bit, and after a couple of hours it's fine to open the mold, but we only had about a half an hour, so we thought we'd do it a day later. So we'll open up the mold, see what we have. Yeah.
And also I'll give you just a little bit of a talk after I cast it. We're doing this sculpture, obviously, right here. This is a study I did for Walt Whitman's sculpture. Here it is in the same hydrocal with a faux bronze patina. This, of course, will be pure white when we take it out. And then I'll give it a bronze patina. That patina has to be ready to have this on display in 3 weeks' time. And that's cutting it a little bit tight, because you cannot add a patina onto plaster that isn't thoroughly dry and thoroughly hard. And plaster tends to, even though it looks hard and it is hard to the touch, there's still a lot of water in here. And so I'll be taking special precautions over the next couple of weeks before I apply the patina, keeping it in the warm, dry area, and maybe even putting a heat lamp on it for a while to make sure that the plaster will accept the patina. The kinds of patinas I use for bronze always start out with a mixture of black and alcohol, denatured alcohol first, about a 60-40 shellac, orange shellac to alcohol, and then that's to seal the plaster. The second coating is about 80% shellac and just a little bit of denatured alcohol. And into that, you can mix your bronze powder or whatever coloring you're using. So, let's open this on the side, pull this off, and the plaster mother mold is coming off. This to reveal the silicone rubber mold inside. And now we'll pull off one side. As though we have a nice smooth casting. Virtually no air pockets, or a couple of minor ones down at the bottom of the beard. So before pulling the back off, I'll explain to you that once hydrocal or plaster is hard, it's not patchable as easily as if it were just cast. If it were simply just cast and hard enough to the touch, you could simply add more hydrocal here. But because this is hard, if you tried to add hydrocal to that little hole right here, this would absorb water so quickly that it would make that little bit of plaster even harder than the sculpture, and therefore harder to make it look in good shape. So you'd have to spray this with water wherever there is a hole. You have to get that very, very wet, and then you would mix up a hydrocal that is a little bit looser, a little bit more watery, because this will still take on that as quickly as possible. Pulling off the back mold. Back rubber, not as much detail on the back, of course, So this should come off much more easily. Lay them back carefully into their molds so that they do not warp. And we have a pretty clean casting on the back as well. And because I did the sculpture in two steps and put it together, there are some seam line issues. And that can be taken care of with a number of different kinds of tools. You can simply cut away the areas that are not quite right, where the seam lines were. So, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this sculpture of Whitman. I call it I Sing the Body Electric, and it was a study for this large 8.5 foot tall Whitman with butterfly that I've made 5 castings of. Two of them are in the town where he was born, Huntington, Long Island, New York. Two of them are in the city where I spent the last 14 years of his life editing the last version of Leaves of Grass in Camden, New Jersey. And one happens to be at a sculpture park near Tokyo in Japan. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it.